Now that we discussed the logistic regression model in great detail and looked at some of the advanced features of PyTorch, let's actually implement a logistic regression classifier in PyTorch. So in this notebook, we are going to reuse a lot of the code from Unit 2. So the installation of the libraries is exactly the same. Then we also use the same dataset as before, so just that we can focus on the model and don't get distracted by the details of the dataset. So as we also can see, we are still dealing with the same two-dimensional dataset. However, a little addition now is that we apply the standardization procedure here to normalize the dataset. And we will discuss what this means in detail in the upcoming video. So for now, just assume we apply this code to standardize the dataset. And as a consequence, we can now see that the dataset features are clustered around zero, or they are centered at zero. And also the spread is a little bit smaller here. So this is an important step to make the logistic regression training smoother. In the next video, we will discuss this again in more detail. Now we are getting to the interesting part, implementing the logistic regression classifier. Here I have the old perceptron code from the previous unit, and now we are going to update this to implement the logistic regression classifier. So let's change the name of the perceptron to logistic regression. Then we are also inheriting from the torch_nn.module class. Next, we are also going to clean up the init function a little bit here. So let's get rid of this and replace this with a linear layer that we just introduced in the previous video. Next, we can also simplify our forward method here. So here we have a lot of custom code that we can replace now by calling the linear layer that we just constructed in the init method. So we first use the linear layer to compute the logits. So here the logits, that's just a technical term for the weighted sum. We can also compute the class membership probabilities using the torch sigmoid function. However, remember what we discussed in the previous video, we can also use a different loss function that works directly with the logits. So here we are just doing this explicitly, the step of computing the probabilities. However, in later neural networks, we will actually skip this step. What's also nice is that we can actually get rid of this update method to simplify it further. And that's because we can later use the step function of the optimizer in PyTorch to update the model automatically. Yeah, and this is really it. So the logistic regression classifier is a really simple model when we implement it in PyTorch. So let's actually initialize a logistic regression model and see if it works. Oops, I see there is a little typo. I forgot the S here. So let's try again. Oh, I see just another typo I made. I forgot another thing here. And this is the super call. So here we are adding this line of code here, which will actually call the init function of the module here, which is really necessary so that the logistic regression model here inherits all the good things that we need from the module to make the training work later. Okay, now it finally works. Let's give it a try on a training data point and see what the prediction is. So here we can see the predicted class membership probability for this data point is 0.433. So the probability that this data point belongs to class 1 is 40.33%. So notice also that I use this function torch no grad here and put it into this with context. So here, this means that we are disabling the construction of the computation graph in the background in PyTorch. Here in this case, we don't need this computation graph to compute the gradients because we are just using the model for prediction. So this is always a recommended best practice to save computer memory and to make the model prediction run faster. Right now, for logistic regression, this might seem overkill, but it will become very relevant when we train deep neural networks later. So now that we have implemented the logistic regression classifier, in the next video, we will implement the training loop and train it on our dataset.